Good morning students, in the last lecture we discussed about the shape of the liquid and the factors affecting the surface tension. Now in this lecture we are going to discuss about the excess pressure inside the liquid drop, which is also known as Laplace's law. Here we are going to derive a relation for the excess pressure inside the liquid drop. For that, consider a liquid drop of radius r. Consider a liquid drop of radius r. Now, in this case, the pressure inside the liquid drop is equal to Pi. And the surface area in this case, A1, is equal to 4 pi r squared. A liquid drop of radius r having the pressure Pi and the surface area in this case is equal to 4 pi r square. Now, if we apply some pressure, to this liquid drop, the volume of the liquid drop increases. So, consider that the liquid drop, the surface of the liquid drop increases by radius delta r. In this case, the total radius of the sphere is equal to r plus delta r, and the area, surface area A2 is equal to 4 pi r plus delta r square. So, we are going to derive a relation for the excess pressure. Here, we know that pressure and volume, they are inversely proportional to each other for a constant temperature. So, we can say that if the pressure here is greater, then the volume must be less. Or the volume is less, then the pressure inside the liquid drop is greater. And if this volume of the liquid drop increases, the pressure also decreases. So we can say that what is the excess of pressure? The excess of pressure is nothing but is equal to Pi minus P. So now, what is the change in the surface area of this liquid drop when it changes its radius from r to r plus delta r? So we can write here this A1 is equal to, it is equal to 4 pi r square, and what is A2 is equal to? This A2 is equal to 4 pi r plus delta r and bracket square. So here it is equal to 4 pi, this is r square twice r delta r plus delta r square. Here this delta r square we can neglect because the value of delta r is very small, and if we square this value it becomes lesser and lesser. So we can neglect this delta r square. So we can write here as it is equal to 4 pi r square plus 8 pi r delta r. This is equal to 8. Now, what is the increase in the surface area? This is the larger area, this is the smaller area. So, what is the increase in the surface area delta A is equal to? It is equal to A2 minus A1, and we can see that this A1 is equal to 4 pi r square and A2 is equal to this. If 4 pi r square get cancelled, and here it is remaining 8 pi r delta r. This is the change in the surface area. Now we know some work must be done to increase the surface area, because What is the surface tension? Surface tension try to minimize the surface area, but here the surface area get increased, and to increase the surface area some work must be done. So we can write here this dW is equal to the surface tension multiplied by the change in area, that is increase in area in this case. So we can write this dW is equal to this T into 8 pi r delta r. So this work done, we can determine in another way, that is this dW is equal to this force multiplied by this distance. We know the formula for work done equal to force multiplied by displacement. So we can write, what is force equal to? This force is equal to pressure. Multiplied by area, that is surface area. What is the pressure? The pressure is nothing but the axis pressure, which will increase from the value P, decrease from the value PI to PO. So we can write here axis of pressure is equal to PI minus PO, and multiplied by the surface area is equal to 4 pi r square. So what is the dW? This dW is equal to pi minus po into 4 pi r square multiplied by delta. So we can equate these two equations and we get the equation for excess of pressure. So we can write here pi minus po into 4 pi r square delta r is equal to, it is equal to T into 8 pi r delta r. So if we cancel this pi and pi, this delta r and delta r, we can write here after simplification pi minus po is equal to twice t divided by r. So this is the equation for the axis of pressure required to increase the radius of the liquid drop by delta r. Now if we take soap bubble. What is soap bubble? Soap bubble has two surfaces, inner surface and outer surface. So this equation changes to pi minus po is equal to 4t upon r. So by using these equations we can determine the axis pressure inside the liquid drop and inside the soap bubble, which is also called as the Laplace's law. Now we are going to see why the shape of the liquid drop or soap bubble is spherical in nature. It is spherical in nature because the forces due to the surface tension dominate over the gravitational force. And we also know what surface tension does. Surface tension decreases the surface area of the liquid. And why this liquid drop and soap bubble does not collapse? They does not collapse because the resultant of the excess external force and the forces due to the surface tension are smaller than the pressure inside the soap bubble or liquid drop. So here we see that what is the excess pressure inside the liquid, which is also called the Laplace's law. These are two equations. This equation is applicable for the liquid drop and this is applicable for the soap bubble. Here we are going to stop now. In the next lecture we are going to discuss about a very important phenomena which is called as a capillarity or capillary action. Today it is goodbye and have a nice day.